What's up, YouTube? So I'm here on a fresh, brand new user on macOS Sierra, and I want to show you guys today how I set up a new user. So I've been using macOS for years and years and years and years, and I love the platform. It's very manageable. It's really easy to use, except when it's out of box like this. Now, I don't know why Apple hasn't changed it. Although, thank you for keeping all of the hidden best features of macOS still there over the years. But I'm going to show you guys how I configure my systems. So this is a 15-inch Retina MacBook Pro, and we're going to just set it up. I literally made the user, opened it up, and started ScreenFlow. So this is as fresh as you could get. This is what you would get when you buy your MacBook in the store. So let's begin. The first thing, and this one I just don't get, the touchpad, the click. You have to actually physically press and click to select an item, and I just want to be able to tap. I'm very used to the tap. That was the whole point of Apple's touch trackpad years and years and years ago. But I don't know if you guys can hear it, maybe not because the microphone's a little low, but that click when you have to tap just drives me nuts. So in here, the first thing I do is come in here and turn up the turn the tap to click. And then I turn my tracking speed up because I like to jump around the screen a lot quicker. This is a setting you may not want to change. It is completely up to you. While I'm in here, the other gesture that is enabled that I just don't understand is show desktop. What you do is you use like a pinch sort of thing. I can't even do it. There you go. So why this is useful, I don't know. Because it throws all the windows away. So all you see is the picture. I guess if you want to show somebody your picture and then try to figure out how to get back into it. So I shut that one off as well. I won't spend too much time explaining each feature. I just wanted to throw those two out as a default. They're really annoying, and I wish Apple would update that and change it. So we're in system preferences here, and there's a few things that I usually like to go in and change. So in general here, I like the scroll bar to appear on either Safari or Chrome or email or wherever I am. So I always change that. That's up to you. And then in recent documents, depending on the user and what I'm using it for, sometimes I'll leave that on, but I also like to change that. I just don't find it useful. I rarely come up here and go to my recents. They're gone now because there is none. And I'm happy with the rest of the options in here. The next thing I do is go into my dock, and I usually change the size, which notably, you can actually go to this little line right here, and if you click, actual physical click and hold, you can scale it any size you'd like. I don't turn magnification on, some people do, I just don't. For desktop, of course, I don't want to stare at the same desktop as everybody else. Let's just be boring. You know what? We'll change it to that. There you go. Again, these are very simple things. So, display. Depending on the user that's already set up, you might not actually want to change this. But if this is your first time using your MacBook, it's going to be set on a default scale. It's going to look something like this. Hopefully, the screen capture captures this. Basically, if you have a Retina MacBook, you can get more space out of your screen by utilizing those extra pixels in the screen. So they actually display at a 2.5K, I believe it is, resolution, so you can choose the scaling. You can actually sit kind of in the middle if you want something that's a little better. I do a lot of video editing, so I like it to have the most space available so that the editors are large and you actually have room to work. So that's basically it from here. We might jump back in a couple other times. There are a few other things like in security you can change, but I'm going to focus on the desktop right now and Finder. So one of the first things I like to do is go up here to Finder and then Preferences. Here in Preferences, I don't know why, but I want to see my main hard drive. You're going to access this drive a lot. It's also great for opening a separate Finder window since for some reason, if you have a Finder window open and you go to click down here, you actually have to go new Finder window to open another window. It'd be really nice if you could just double tap this icon right here and get another Finder window. So having your hard drive there, if you don't have external drives plugged in, is really nice. Another thing I like to do is select the connected servers, because I do connect to a few servers in my house here, and I have network drives, so I like to be able to see those network drives, and they'll appear as so here. So if you have a network drive and you want it to appear, you will have to have this option available. And then the last thing I like to do is, in new Finder windows, I like to be redirected to my home directory, which contains like music, documents, and all that kind of stuff, because I usually work out of those folders. And you can actually, if you're working off of an external or something else like that that's always plugged in, you can actually choose a different directory there. So Apple does offer some of those. And then if you're working off of iCloud Drive, you can do the same thing. In here with tags, I usually just kind of leave this alone, but I go over here to sidebar and I change, or add, I should say, all of these options here. And what these are in this Finder window here are all the links, so that you don't just have to go to the home folder, which normally you would just go to your name. I can find it right there. So you'd have all of these folders here. You can actually have movies and music on the sidebar. I also don't like this, all my files. It's stupid. You can't find anything in it anyways. You're going through thousands of files. Why does it default to all my files? It makes your computer take forever to load. So I remove it. Again, these features, you can leave them as customized as you will. It's just how I personally set up my device. Last thing I do in here is select to actually see the MacBook in devices, and then I turn off the tags because I do not use the tags. I know a lot of people were out for the tags and were really happy that Apple implemented that, and kudos to them, but I don't use it. Another thing I like to enable here and in the advanced is show all extensions on files. So if you have a .jpg or something like that, you can actually see the .jpg extension. It'll be there. And then I like to have this selected, although I usually do it myself if I were to forget. And that's all I really change in here. While I have my Finder window open, usually I pick a Finder window that has some items in it. So we'll actually go to applications. The default layout on this is actually not too bad. And same with this one here. But unfortunately, sometimes, that wasn't good. Sometimes you'll find folders look like this. They'll just be scattered all over the place, and that is not productive. This is actually default, and it drives me crazy that Apple, they have a great sorting mechanism built into Finder, and it's not enabled by default. So how you do this, you open up whatever window looks absolutely horrible, like this one here that I've created. Create the size you'd like your regular Finder windows to open. So usually I like it to be a modest size, but something I can move around the screen like this. You can see the layout's all horrible there. So click in an open white space and go to this show view options. So in here, the first thing you're going to want to do, I usually choose open as an icon view. You don't have to do this if you like the list view. I don't like the list view unless I have a breakdown of a whole bunch of movies or TV shows or something like that. It's the only time I ever find it really useful. Arrange by, I usually set as name. And as you can see there, it cleans up the folder. It adjusts to the size. Why is this not default? All right, and then the last thing I do here is put show all items, so that you can see within folders what the items are. Now, before, when I was speaking about the show all extensions, as you can see here, the names of my movies and stuff like that actually have a .mov or .mp4. So that's what I meant by showing those. Now, let's say you like this window and you want all windows to open up like this. you need to click the Use as Default. When you change an item in here, so if I were to change this to kind, and it would sort them by kind, I need to just sort them by name. It's not a big deal to me. It'll open up this Use as Default. So now when I open up any other window, they're still going to appear with that same sort of layout. So even your externals, everything you plug into it, it's not going to be all mixed up and crazy like it was before, and it can't jump out of grid. So you can actually view your files, and it's nice and organized. All right, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to change our Finder window up here. Apple actually introduced in, I believe it was Yosemite, a tab system for Finder, and it's really handy, but it's, again, hidden by default. So in any Finder window, you just go up here to View, and from View, you're going to want to go Show Tab Bar. You can also turn on, which I'm going to actually turn on, Show Path Bar, which will actually show you where you're at in your directory tree. And then I like to go Show Status Bar, which will show me the items available in the folder and the available disk space on this folder particular, so which hard drive you're on. If you're on a different drive like here, it'll display the stuff, and then it'll display the amount of disk space available. I like this because I can create multiple tabs in one Finder window. I can drag between them, which is really easy. You could jump in, you know, drag from folder to folder to folder, and it's just handy to have on default when you open it up, so that you don't have to select, because you can't go here and make a new Finder window. So it's just easier that you can create a tab, create a tab, create a tab. And I like that. So I like having that available by default, just so that you don't have to go File and then New Tab to create a new tab. Or you can alternatively go down here. Actually, you have to create a new folder. A new window. And then the last thing I really like to do is change up the way my desktop is. So if you exit everything out and you're back to your desktop here, you can right click and go Show View. And again, this is going to be the same as when we set the default for all of our Finder windows. But the desktop is a little different. So I usually actually set the grid on the desktop to as far as possible. I don't normally cloud my desktop up, and if I do want to have a lot of files on my desktop, I usually keep it at that default. Now the reason I do this is because I go here and I go Show All Info. It's nice to be able to see how much is on these drives, the available space, so the detailed information, without actually having to select the drive or go get info. And then of course I also do the sort by name, so it's nice to have all the drives sorted and snapping to a grid. This one here, you don't have to click a set as default because it is just specific to the desktop, and you can exit out of there. So from there, you can kind of customize Mac OS a little more. You can grab, drag, move things around, make it look like your own. Go on the internet, pick up a couple wallpapers, and have fun with it. So I wish Apple would change it with their default settings so that it was a little easier for people to use. I believe that if it was laid out something more like this, it would just be a lot easier. You can see I like to make a lot of changes with my Macs, but I still absolutely love Macs. They work so well, and they're so easy to use once they're set up properly. So kudos to Apple for making a great product. Thanks to you guys for watching these videos. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel. Give it a thumbs up. If you don't like it, give it a thumbs down. We'll see you guys again next time. Cheers.